Hello gamers, I'm Mortuary and welcome back to another Scorched Earth modded series video to Stunt and Dingen. Hello gamers, I'm Mortuary and welcome back to another modded Ark Scorched Earth video. And as you can see, I got my builder's helmet on, so I think it's time to continue the building of our cathedral. I know last time things were horribly wrong at some points, and I'm hoping to have a little bit more luck today. I would love to finish the first level today, but for that I will need lots of pillars and some of these glass walls here. And you see I already made 75 of them. I still have enough metal and other stuff to make another 25. But luckily, before I started recording, I went on a little trip with my harvest Ankylo, and I brought some metal back. Normally I should have a few thousand metal, I think. Yeah, 10,000 metal. I'm going to pull that into my S+. Refining forge, which I put on top of here, but that doesn't really matter since I can pull in everything. So pull resources, raw metal. There we go. Pull it all in. Done. Turn it on. And by the time I have finished placing these 100 S+ glass things, the metal should be ready and I should be able to cook some more. I also brought back some crystal. Yep, crystal should have plenty on the harvest, Anki. So I think I should have enough stuff to make whatever I need. Let me check one more time. Large glass. You see, the thing I'm missing is probably metal. Yeah. So I will let this metal cook just a little bit, and meanwhile I will be placing the rest of the stuff. And we can continue the building adventures. I really hope things will go a lot better than yesterday. I already brought a lot of materials, building blocks, to the little storage box I have up there. And I removed one wall so I don't really have to walk all around the thing constantly. So I'm going to be starting at the back of the cathedral. And I will be putting up some glass walls up there. So this is the area where we will be starting today, and I'm going to be putting the glass walls on my number 5 slot, and I will be putting them up on top of these adobe things. Let me put a few up and then I will show you what I will be doing with that. I'm not quite sure yet what I will be doing. Maybe I will be putting up pillars from the top to the bottom on every one of those. Or maybe I will even leave one double one. Because you can change this. For example, if you press and hold the E, you can cycle the direction in which you can see through the glass. I will be leaving that like it is. You can cycle the model. Oh, this is nice too. Oh, there are two models. No, there are plenty of models. Oh, nice. This is looking even better than I thought. Yeah, I have one big glass wall then. I can even remove the bottom part and the top part. That's all perfect. Yeah, this one has a bottom part but no top part. And this one just has the sides. I'm gonna have to play with that. Yeah, this is the default one, I think. Yeah. And you can also trigger this, select model, and then you can switch which one you want yourself. For example, if I want only the three sides, not this one, I think this one, yeah, done. Then you will see it. I have the top side, the left side, and the bottom side. And I can cycle this one to the A, I think. No. To the D. Yeah, of course. And then I have the same result. I have one big open glass wall. So I'm not quite sure what I will do with that yet, since I might be putting in pillars up till the bottom. But let me place the glass walls really quick, and then we can come back to check a few other things.
Let's go back to that little place where we used to go in the summer days. The lodge by the water's still my favorite place, and I could come every year and it wouldn't change.
Okay, back again with an update. I've placed all my glass walls. I just had enough up until here, but it doesn't really matter because right here I forgot to add something. I should be removing these and putting up some foundations and other things, because this is the area where I will have my towers, and I seem to have forgotten that. So let me do a few things here, remove the walls, put up some foundations, and try to have the basic structure my towers, of course. Let me go back and grab a few things. I should have plenty of materials in here, but I'm gonna start with foundations. Yeah, I still have quite a few of those. So the front, really the complete front, should be two blocks wider. This will be difficult to place, true. Oh no, I can see them right here. Come on, place. Yeah. I think if my calculations are right, then it should be approximately something like this. Two blocks wider, then four blocks. Yep, that should be it. Now I have to do the same thing on this side. Let me clear the area first though, because I don't really want these plants to stick out of my ceilings and foundations. My foundations should go two blocks out and four blocks like this. Yep, this is perfect. So then I should be placing some walls up here. This makes the tower approximately four blocks by four blocks. Yep, perfect. Same thing on this side, make it a little bit wider to accommodate the two big towers. Now I have a few foundations left. I will be putting those in the front because I want to extend it a little bit. I think two or three foundations out should be enough. Oh, no, not like that. Yep, like this. So I'm going to be closing this up with foundations now. And this is the main entrance. So I will be building some gates or putting up some gates here. Yep, like this. And one more. And one more. One more. And this should be almost it. Now I just need to fill it up with foundations. and I'm ready for the next step of the building. I think next up I will be placing some, well, maybe I should be placing some gates, but I'm not quite sure if I have those already. So I'm going to have to check if I have enough materials to build gates. And yeah, if not, then I will have to go gather some stuff because I didn't build those yet. I don't really need the doors to start with, but I definitely... Oh, I'm missing two. Yeah, and I should put up some ramps as well. So I need about five more foundations and a few ramps. Yeah, I can pick half of those. Do I have any ramps? Yep, I have a few. Let's hurry back to the front and place the last few foundations to close up everything. And yeah, put up some ramps. Oh, it did do it. I'm going to put up some ramps up here. Maybe I will be changing that later on, but that way I can easily move from one level to the other one and even bring some dinos up if need be. I should have enough with three to bring up most dinosaurs as well. Okay, that's done. Ooh, this one snaps differently. That's probably a default one. Yeah. Oh no, it's an S plus. Huh, strange. Well, it doesn't really matter. So now you have a better idea of how big the building will be. Of course, I still need to do a few things now. And that's put up the basic things for the towers up here. I'm going to check if I have some materials to make two gates and one behemoth gate now. Quickly checking if I have some in here. No, no gates. So that means I will have to go inside my building and check if I have everything I need up there. I'm hesitating. I don't think I have the materials to make enough gates. There we go. And I think I have the gates too now, so I can go ahead and place them. Let me hurry back to the building site. And the good thing about these S-plus gates is that they will snap to the existing foundations. So it might be a little bit easier to place them. Okay, this is the northern entrance, so I need one of those in here. You see, it immediately snaps and I love that. Oh, did it place outside or inside? That's the only thing I have no idea about. Well, I don't think you can see the difference. For now, it doesn't really matter. I can pick them up anyway. One like this. Ah, no. Oh, yeah, it did do it. You might notice that it isn't the same height as the glass walls. Well, no worries. I will be placing some ceilings up there in a few minutes, and then I can place the remaining little walls in those areas. Right here, I will be doing the same thing. So, two gates on each side. Well, one on each side, which makes two of them in total. Yep, like this. And then I should be able to place two more walls. Yeah, normally I should. It should work. One. Oh, no, no, not like this. On the inside of this block, yep. And on the inside of that block. Perfect. And I think I made it just like this. Yep. I think I did. Same thing on this side. One. Oh, no, that's wrong. And one, another one on the inside of the foundation where I'm standing on. Perfect. One here. And bring it up a little bit. And last but not least, the big behemoth gate. I will be placing that right in front of here. This one might require some fiddling around. No, that's not the way I wanted it. I'm not quite sure if this is what I had in mind. Okay, let's have a look from the front. This is indeed starting to look like some form of a big building. So this is starting to look pretty much okay to me. And I think it is time to start working on the rest of the building. Gonna have one more look from this side. Yep, this is starting to look the way I expected it. Okay, next up, I will have to build some scaffolding because I want to place some ceilings up top. Meanwhile, I will go inside and build some more of those glass walls because I will need tons and tons of those. So I'm heading inside, building a few more things, and I will get back to you guys when I have everything ready and we can continue with the rest of the build. Okay, it's update time. What did I do? Well, the only thing I did was build a few things in inside, and I set up this little ramp because I will have to place ceilings all around the building. And that was the only way to get up top. I tried it with my Argent Tarvis, but it was too difficult to aim and place everything. So I'm going to be doing this all around the the lower part of the building. And then we should be able to continue. So let me do that really quick. And I will get back to you guys when I have an update for you. Okay, I'm back with another update, and as you can see, I did place ceilings all around the thing. The only problem I have is since this side is built upon fence foundations and this side is built upon the foundations themselves, so it doesn't really match 100%. Like, for example, if I would show you, this ceiling goes below the other one. I don't really mind all that much because, well, yeah, I have no other way of doing it. And, well, you won't be noticing it all that much, I think. I wish I could do it differently, but there is no way to do it. I have the same problem on this side, you see. It doesn't match up 100%, but I think I should be able to live with that. No, next step, I should be placing foundations all around this thing. Now, let me show you. Why can I show you that really quick? Yeah, I can show that. I'm gonna go grab some normal fence foundations. These are S plus ones. Let me think, do I have some normal ones? I really hope this will work because earlier, well, yesterday, during the previous episode, I had troubles placing my fence foundations on ceilings. Oh no, it will work. I want them on the outside of the ceiling, not on the inside. So let me have a look. Yeah, this is perfect. Let me place a few of those and then I will be showing you what I mean or why I want it like that. Oh no, this is easier. Look, with the normal fence foundations, now it's on the inside of the ceiling, and when you press Q, it will try to snap to another snap point, and it snaps to the outside. I like that. I will have to go down to show that. So I want to snap some pillars to it, to make it a little bit more, well, finishing touches, I would say. I'm gonna place some pillars in my slot on my hotbar. Get out and hope that I can jump that high. If not, I will have to make foundations. Well, not foundations, but scaffolding on this side too. Yeah, I think I will have to. So, like this. And normally, if I would place... Yeah, that's what I wanted. You see, I can place pillars now on every corner of every fence foundation. And that's what I wanted. If I would have used... Those fence foundations at the bottom, I could have started from the bottom and work upwards, but now I will have to do it like this. Actually, maybe I should just stay here. Nah, I will have to go to the lower, I think. Let me remove that. I know in S Plus you have some very large pillars too, like medium pillars and large pillars. Maybe if I can snap a medium one to those, I won't have to build a scaffolding all around it. Well, not at all individual levels. This is a medium one. Encumbered. Why am I encumbered? It doesn't matter. So I have them on the number 8 slot. No, it seems to be not working at all. And that's the same thing I had in single player. I was unable to snap the big pillars on the bottom side, but I was able to do it on the top side. And that was also something strange. You see, I can see... Oh, there it was. Oh no, it's on the corner of my ceiling. I have to pay attention with that. That's not what I... Huh? That is what I want. But will it be removed when I remove this one? I bet it will. Oh no, it isn't. Nice, then I can try with foundations like this. Then I need a lot less. I will have to fill the gap though. Oh, and I placed this one incorrectly. Yep. Well, let me work on this. And I will get back to you guys once I have an update for you.
Let's go back to that little place where we used to go in the summer days. We dip our feet at the water's edge and everyone would come along to meet us there. We'll have a competition to see who can tread for longer, 'cause every year my body's getting stronger. We can swim all day and dance until the night, but we're not coming home till the moonlight shines, till the moonlight shines. Thank you.
Well, here I'm back with another update. I finished placing all the fence foundations at the second floor, and those will be used to attach pillars to them. Now, one thing you should pay attention to when placing your fence foundation is that you place them on the outside of your ceiling. For example, let me show you. Yeah, now it places it correctly, of course. I'm gonna try again. Yeah, of course, when you want to show the problem, Ark places everything correctly, of course. Yeah, okay, let me try one more time. Aha, now I have one. You see the difference? It doesn't line up perfectly. And you know it's on the inside if you see the little bits of the ceiling sticking out from under the fence foundation. So this one is actually on the outside of the foundation, and this one is on the inside. So I should be removing that one and place it again. Now you can cycle through snap points by pressing Q and the Z key. So that should help you place it correctly. Now I don't really need these. I finished placing the fence foundations. And next up I will be adding the pillars all around. And once that is done, I will show you the result. It will probably take me a while before I finish that. But once that is done, you should have already a better idea of what I'm trying to achieve here. So let me do some more building, some more placing of pillars, and I will get back to you guys when I have an update. We'll be right back. Well, guys, I think it's time for another little update. And as you can see, I have finished almost the complete inside. Yeah, maybe better to wait a little bit longer because, well, it's early in the morning and lighting is not all that good. So I have finished the contours, the outside, and I had to place some, how do you call that? Some scaffolding, yeah, scaffolding around the building, because I couldn't really get to the top part to place my pillars up there. And I had to, yeah, be a little bit creative and put some ceilings all around the building in order to jump on them from the top and do whatever I had to do. So the only thing I have to do now is remove all the scaffolding. And once that is done, I will show you a little video, a little bit of what I have done from the outside. I will grab my bird and fly around, one of those stupid wolves again, and will show you what I have done so far.
Let's go back to that little place where we used to go in the summer days. The lodge by the water's still my favorite place, and I could come every year and it wouldn't change.
Okay, folks, I think it's time for the final update. This is what I have done. Let me show you from the outside. So this is the clover I was mentioning earlier or last time. I finished everything. The outside, the contours are up. I added my gates to the northern side. I didn't put any doors in it yet, but that doesn't matter at all. I finished everything by placing pillars to separate the different windows. I'm not quite sure if I should add more pillars to it. I'm not sure. I could make the windows a lot smaller by dividing them again, but that would require a lot more materials. And it's not all too bad like this. Now, from the front side, this is how it looks. I have one main gate and two side gates, and both two side gates are part of a tower which will be rather high. The same thing on the other side, actually. I finished it in the same way. I removed all the excessive ceilings I had put up, and this is how it looks from the inside. Well, it's not really done from the inside. Normally, let me land. So I put up some stairs, some ramps which go to the top of the tower. And on this side, I finished it with the pillars. I'm not quite sure if I should do it with pillars like this and maybe close it up, or maybe leave it completely open like this side. I'm not quite sure. Suggestions are welcome, of course. And this is how it looks from the inside. Now, this inside part isn't finished at all. Normally, let me check my paper, my little design. Normally, I should have another row of pillars in the middle here and on this side too. So I think two blocks in, I will be putting up some pillars. And this will be a whole row of pillars up until the end. Up until here somewhere. And similarly, on this side, I still need to add pillars on this row as well. But that will be for next time, I think. I think I have done enough building for this session. Now, it's starting to give a pretty good idea about how it will look. As I mentioned, I still need to do some building on the inside, adding some pillars, and well, add more stuff. This is only the first level. So I'm going to be adding another level just like this one. Well, almost exactly the same. And then it's time to put up the roofs and finish the towers. Let me move out of the way a little bit. So this is how it looks like from the side. And let me try to get a little bit higher now. Oh, yeah, K mode. You can't fly up in K mode. I should have known that by now. And that's approximately how it will look from the top. Okay, this is still the first level, as I mentioned. I will be adding a second level like that. And then we will be adding some roofs on the backside, sloped roofs. And in the front, there will be two towers. It isn't really looking like the Cathedral de Reims yet, but it's starting to look pretty similar to it. But as I mentioned, this is all the building I can handle for today. So if you like this video, feel free to hit the thumbs up button. Comments and suggestions on the build are always more than welcome in the comment section below the video. And if you would rather get in touch with me personally, then you will find me on Twitter, Facebook, Ask.fm and all other social media websites. And you will find links to those in the description as well. As usual, there is one more thing you could do. If you want to support me and my building endeavors, then feel free to hit the subscribe button. Not only do you really help me out with that, you help me reach my next subscriber goal, but you will also get notified when I post new content to the channel. Well, I guess that will be it for today. Until next time, have fun and stay safe. Bye.